Hi, so this is going to be the first video for See the Civ, and I've got two films that I'm going to be reviewing for you today, so let's get right to the trailer.
This thing. No conscience. Just hunger. The rider's going to come out. And when he does, he'll destroy whoever's got it coming.
He'll take on a new form. One more powerful than he's ever known.
Not afraid of you.
Oh, that's awesome.
I saw this movie yesterday on Blu-ray. I watched the first one on DVD a couple of years ago. I really liked the character. I was a little bit unsure that Nicolas Cage should be doing it because I didn't think Johnny Blaze, the Ghost Rider, was necessarily that age, but he seemed to be having fun with it. Even though I didn't like his haircut in it, he looked like the older version of Zac Efron. But anyway, what did I think about Ghost Rider: Spirit of a Vengeance? First of all, we've got to establish that this is not a sequel to the Mark Steven Johnson's version of Ghost Rider way back when. This is a sort of reboot. He did hop on to the executive producer credits, but essentially everything that he built up in that movie was taken away. Even the origin story of Ghost Rider was sort of diminished and replaced with another one. So Kieran Hines can come in as the bad guy. I think it's Rorch or Roach or whatever his name is. He's basically Satan. In the previous one, it was Peter Fonda with Mitophysite. I can't pronounce his name. I don't know why they come up with complicated names, really. Anyway, I'm droning on. What did I think about the movie? Well, I wanted to see this movie in the cinema, and I didn't get a chance, so I waited for it to come out on Blu-ray. I rented it out and was a little bit disappointed with it. The directors who directed Crank sort of got this style that I like, you know, the sort of music video, if you were on crack type thing. And this doesn't let down on that. It is very much like watching a music video on crack, except that they seem to be having more fun doing it than the audience has fun watching it. It was very poorly received at the box office by many critics, receiving a maximum of 2 stars. Most gave it 0 or 1. Yes, it didn't receive fantastic reviews. So yeah, I enjoyed The Ride a little bit, but I think they could have had a bit more fun with it. Yeah, made it a bit more for the audience, really. So, see this if you like Nicolas Cage's acting, or not. Sometimes it's always good to laugh at his movies. I don't think he's made a really good movie since 1997, or when Face Off was made. So, yeah, there's my review. I'm going to give that a big fat one star. Right, let's move on to the next review, which is on The Darkest Hour. Before I start talking about it, let's watch the trailer.
Welcome to Moscow.
Look at this place.
One, two, three.
Eliminate, scusate, scusate.
I've never seen anything like this.
Human casualties are massive. It's impossible to make visual contact.
They're absorbing all our power supplies.
This wasn't just Moscow. New York, London, Paris, Tokyo, all reported invisible invaders.
They came here with a plan. They can see us, but we can't see them.
What do they want?
Energy, electricity.
Oh my God.
Get inside!
The way it lit up that cop car, electricity gives it away. Warning devices.
Go, go!
We're gonna fight the hell back.
So, The Darkest Hour, as we've just watched there, appears more to be the darkest hour of the director than anything to do with the movie. As we've just seen from the trailer, the storyline is these beings that are invisible are apparently made up of electrical energy of some sort. It is explained in the movie, but very, very skirted over. I mean, they don't really want to focus on the science of it, they want to focus more on the action. But anyway, I thought it was a rather inventive way of playing on this typical storyline of apocalypse, etc. You know, I'm always liking films that don't seem to show the enemy that you're always scared. That's why I liked the film Signs, if you remember that film. Until the end, what I like to do is I sort of like cut it just before you see the alien at the end, that sort of makes it the movie for me. Anyway, I didn't enjoy The Darkest Hour because the script was quite bad. It was laughably bad. It's got some really, really bad lines in it. You can even see the actors sort of wince at saying, "Do I have to say this?" sort of expression. But anyway, regardless of that, as I was watching it, the Australian bird from Transformers popped up, and I think she's a bit more memorable now in the film Hall Pass when she gets naked. I don't think many men will forget that. Anyway. The Darkest Hour. I don't recommend it. See this if you are up late at night and you're looking for something to watch other than the sign language on BBC television news. So, yeah. I'm going to give The Darkest Hour a big fat one star. That's the end of my first video review. I hope you like it. I do apologise for the appalling Windows Movie Maker transitions, etc. I apologise for the webcam, I apologise for the sound. I think you can hear my computer fan whirling away there. So I do apologise for that. If I do get more views on this, then obviously I'll start saving up for better camera equipment, etc. So let me know in the comments section below whether you like this or not, and we'll see what happens. I'm very excited about this. Bye for now. Until next time.